Genesis chapter 8, verse 1 to verse 4. Genesis chapter 8, verse 1 to 4. And God remembered Noah and every living thing, and all the cattle that were within him in the ark. And God made a wind to pass over the earth, and the waters as wheat. The fountains also of the deep and the windows of the heaven were stopped, and the rain from heaven was restrained, and the water returned from off the earth continually. And after the end of the 150 days, the waters were abated. And the ark rested in the seventh month, on the 17th day of the month, upon the mountains of Ararat. Let us pray. The God of Abraham, Isaac and Jacob, Jehovah You are the man of war. Your mercies endureth forever and ever. Oh, praise his holy name, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You are Jehovah, you are the man of war. Your faithfulness endureth forever and ever. Oh, praise his holy name. All the miracles that happened, that we have just read in that Genesis chapter 8, all of them happened just because the Almighty God remembered Noah. Begin to bless the name of the Lord for the way this our God had remembered you. Magnify him for all the miracles, all the signs, all the wonders the Almighty God had performed in your life. If he had not remembered you, nothing of sort can happen. But bless the name of the Lord because of the way the Lord God himself had made himself available in the affairs of your life. Give him all praise today. Remember the time when you were in darkness. He remembered you and he came and he rescued you. Remember the time when you were down. He remembered you and he came and lifted you up. Remember the time when you are totally lost in the wilderness of life. He entered into that wilderness and he brought you out. Remember the time when you are in the cage of the enemy. He came and he broke the net. And today you can say, like Israel said, the snare is broken and we escape. Bless the name of the Lord. Give him all praise. Give him all honor. Give him adoration. All the barren who were formerly barren that are now, by the special grace of God, you are carrying your children, begin to bless the name of the Lord who remembered you. Give him all praise. Give him all honor. Many of us who had no work before, but today, by the special grace of God, we are earning salary and we are taking care of our family. We are taking care of the things of God. Bless the name of the Lord. The way he has provided for your needs. Magnify him, glorify him. Many of us who were sick before, but the Lord came and rescued us from that sickness and delivered you. Bless the name of the Lord. The Lord who remembered you and are giving you sound health right now. Give him all praise. Give him all honor. Give him all adoration. Our Master God is good. The King of glory is glorious. Magnify him, magnify him, magnify him, magnify him, magnify him, magnify him. Yes, Lord, many of us who were nobody, but the Almighty God came into our lives, and by the special grace of God today, he's lifting us up. Bless the name of the Lord for his faithfulness. Truly, the Lord can pick a beggar from the east and begin to raise him up until he sit down among the princes. Bless the name of the Lord. The Lord, like Joseph, he had remembered you. Oh, give him praise. Give him honor. Give him adoration. Thank you, Father God. Glory be to your holy name. Honor be to your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Now, call upon the name of the Lord. Today, O Lord, remember me. There are a lot of reasons or cases or battles that you are facing with. If God doesn't remember someone, that case, that fellow will perish there. If God didn't remember Noah, the water will not be taken away. The flood will not end. But the Lord remembered Noah. That is the reason why the water will dry up. Pray right now. All the waters of trouble, all the waters of sorrow, all the waters of pain, all the waters of chaotic situation, either in your nation or in your family or your own personal life, pray, call upon the Lord right now. Say, Lord, remember me today. Remember us today. Remember my nation today. Remember my family today. Remember me today, O God. Call upon the name of the Lord. Do not forget that this God answers prayers. He answers prayers and is right there with us one more time. Glorify him. and call upon him, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The Bible says, the righteous runneth into it, and they are secured. Glory be to your holy name, Daddy. We know that today you will remember us. Just the way you remembered Noah, you will remember us. And your name will be glorified. Your power will be manifested. Thank you, Daddy. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Our Daddy God, where can we start from? We remember, like yesterday, all the things you have done in our lives in the past. We cannot deny your faithfulness. We cannot deny your grace. We cannot deny your favor. We cannot deny the way you come into our life and change everything. Almighty God, we bless your name. We adore your name. On behalf of all who are watching right now, who are beneficiary of your faithfulness, of your grace, of your power, we want to say thank you very much. Thank you because of the way you've remembered us in the past. And that's the reason why we could win over all those battles of life. We thank you. Almighty God, we thank you. King of glory, we thank you. Lord of lords, we thank you. Eternal rock of faith, we thank you. Accept our thanksgiving in the mighty name of Jesus. Today, we are here again. Just the way you remembered Noah. Daddy, remember us. Remember us. King of glory, remember us. Ha, we know by the time at the file of our remembrance is open before you, problems and whatever the moment of sorrow and darkness we've been passing through will suddenly be over. Daddy, today, remember us. At the end of everything today, Daddy, let there be salvation. Let there be healings. And let only your name be glorified. Thank you, Daddy, because it is done. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen and amen. Let God hear your voice of hallelujah, of remember right now. Let someone shout hallelujah. Amen. One more time, we want to appreciate our parents in the Lord, our Daddy and Mommy Jill. We are very, very proud of you. Wherever we go at all times. And what the Lord is doing in our lives and in assignment you've committed to our hands, we cannot thank God enough, and we want to appreciate our Daddy and Mommy. Miracles every day, signs and wonders, souls are saved, families are being delivered, several miracles of God that the Lord is performing in our own time. We are highly encouraged to be alive at this particular time of this, our generation. It could be true that all over the world, there are chaotic situations, there are all kinds of troubles around here. But with what God is doing, God is still proving himself to be the Almighty God, to be the King of glory, to be the Lord of lords, to be the eternal rock of ages, to be the I am that I am, to be the one that is mighty in battle and is winning all over again and again and again. That we can see today that God is really fulfilling what he has said in his word, that when the enemies have come like a flood, the spirit of the Lord will raise up a standard against it. That's what the Lord is doing. We appreciate you, our Daddy, our Mommy Adeboye. To God be the glory. Her brethren, as we are considering today the fruits of remembrance, we want to use certain testimonies to pray certain crucial prayer first. By the time I read those testimonies, you will see the reason why we should pray. For number one, Joko Tola from Nigeria, listen to her testimony. My brother fell sick, and he was rushed to the hospital. He was diagnosed of having a mass in his intestine in a private hospital. So we took him to the general hospital, and it was the same prognosis. He was admitted on a Saturday and was to be operated on Monday. But we cried to God, the Lord God of RUCCG prayer ring, and Just before the surgery on Monday, the doctor re-examined him and they would not find the mass again. He was discharged that same day. Imagine a man they discover in the intestine, the private hospital, they diagnosed it. They now brought the young man to the general hospital, the same thing. So they gave him admission that on Monday, operation would take place. They came on that month, the medical personnel, to re-examine him again. And they could not find that particular object inside the intestine any longer. Immediately, they discharged him. This God still performs wonders. You are going to call upon the Lord. Lord, judge the way you intervene. In the affairs of this young man, intervene my life. You know somebody that is sick. Call upon the name of the Lord. You did particular testimony at a point of contact right now. God can reverse the irreversible. They saw it on Saturday from different hospitals. Now they could not see it again because the Almighty God is up there performing signs and wonders and healings. Call upon the name of the Lord. I mentioned the name of that fellow. If the particular issue is not affecting you directly, call the name of that fellow you know, and you are coming back to share your testimonies. Call upon the Lord. Say, Father God, you are the only God who reverting the reversible. What the doctor has said, it is practically impossible to be tackled. You can remove such a thing in a twinkle of an eye. Just the way you have done for this young man, set that fellow free right now in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for all of you crying unto God right now for divine intervention, particularly in the area of healings, in the area of wholeness. The Lord God himself will intervene in the best of your life right away in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Listen to another woman. This one, because of the sensitivity of the testimonies, it will be anonymous. So anonymous from Nigeria. I am the woman whom God healed of 50 years of bedwetting over a year ago in April 2022. Since then, I have not wet my bed again. I'm grateful to God for making my healing permanent. I return all the glory to God for taking away my shame forever. Imagine someone bedwetting. If we're at the age of 50, still bedwetting. But April last year, the Lord God intervened. We read that testimony on the prayer ring platform, April last year. And she's confirming the permanent healing, the permanent deliverance that the Almighty God has wrought in her life today. You are going to call upon the Lord. I don't know what that particular sinful thing that going on your life. It has been there all the way for a long time. The Lord God who delivered this woman is still alive. Call upon the name of the Lord. Say, Lord, every object of sin, every object of sorrow in my life that I've been there for a long time, Almighty God, uproot it today, remove it today, deliver me today. Call upon the name of the Lord. He's here right now. He can do all things for you. This God is Almighty God. There's nothing this our God cannot do. He has rescued this young woman. He can rescue also. Call upon him right now. Call upon him right now. What is that standing problem that have been there? Imagine 50 years old woman, still bedwetting. But the Lord intervened. And the woman waited for one solid year to share the testimony again that he stopped April last year and it had never come again. No, when God performs a miracle, it is permanently done. It is settled forever. Oh, yes, Lord, call upon the name of the Lord. You know the problem. Your own mom be bedwetting. It may be something else. Reveal that thing. Present that case before the Almighty God. It's ready right now to set you free. It's ready right now to settle you. It's ready right now to take away your shame. It's ready right now to lift you up. Call upon him. Call upon him.
Thank you, Father, for having answered. Glory be to your holy name. Honor be to your holy name. Adoration be to your holy name. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen and amen. Let's take one or two more to pray through. This one is also anonymous from Nigeria. Last year, my grandson, who is autistic and in a special school abroad, had stage 4 lymphoma, that is cancer of the blood cells, of the white blood cells. All the system, including the brain and the bones, were affected. The bone marrow was no longer producing red blood cells, and the system were already shutting down. I lifted this to the God of RUCCG prayer rain, and he intervened. After a course of chemotherapy, all the cancer cells disappeared, and there was no need for radiotherapy again. Instead, he was given 3 months follow-up. He is back in school, hale and hearty, and he did very well to the glory of the Lord. This is, medically speaking, a hopeless situation. It's all the system, they're already settling down. But they call upon the Lord, and the Lord intervened. All what they would tell this young man, come back in 3 months' time to examine you again. Because they could not, everything was perfectly okay because the Lord intervened. Call upon the Lord right now concerning your medical issue, concerning your sickness, concerning your ailment, concerning that thing you have been that have been bombarding your life and is and is wrecking down your life, is taking life away from your life. Call upon the name of the Lord. Medically speaking, they have told me it is impossible. They have no solution. Almighty God, arrive for me and intervene, 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 intervene. They have told me my case has no medical solution, oh God. You are the Almighty God. You are the healer. By your stripes, the Bible says, I am healed. Pray right now. That particular situation of your health that is deteriorating, and medically speaking, they said they don't have answer to solve your problem. Daddy God, in the mighty name of Jesus, remember me today and answer me. Oh God, just the way you did for this young man, oh, reversing all the irreversible in my life too. Let your blood, oh God, flush out every impurity in my system. Let your name be glorified in my life. Set me free now. Set me free now. Every pollution in my system, Almighty God, let all be purified right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Glory be to your holy name. Honor be to your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Let now pray for certain family where they have troublesome, rebellious children. Listen to this woman. I'm a young widow, and one of my children have been giving me problems in the last 3 years. She became disobedient, rebellious, exhibiting negative traits, and got involved in a same-sex relationship. It was a sort of sorrow to the family. I brought a case to the God of RUCG prayer rain. I also keyed into testimony of similar cases to pray for her. On the 17th of August, oh my God, she returned home from school, expressed her bitterness and explained why he had been rebellious. And she said she had given her life back to Jesus. And she had been reconciled to the family. I give God glory. Imagine such a child, a young girl for that lady, so rebellious, so stubborn, and to crown the whole thing, she declared herself as lesbian. Imagine the sorrow, imagine the pain, imagine the headache that the family are thrown into, the darkness of life, the entire family are thrown into. But they call upon the Lord, and the Lord answered them. Right now, I don't know the situation that you are facing with your children at home, with your uncle at home, with your wife at home, with your husband at home, with the people around you at home, right there in your family. The Lord God that settled this family by bringing himself available, by making himself available in the life of this daughter, is still alive. Mention their name right now and lift up their name wherever you are. The Lord will settle your family. The Lord will settle your family right away, right away, right away. Call upon the name of the Lord. Mention the name of that boy. Mention the name of that girl. Mention the name of that sister. Mention the name of your husband. Mention the name of your aunt. Mention the name of your wife. Mention their name right now. Mention their names right now. The Lord will intervene. He's still available. This God is still available. The King of Glory is still available. The Lord of Lords is still available. He will rescue your family. He will deliver you. He will deliver you. Yes, he will deliver you. King of Glory will deliver you. Lord of Lords will deliver you. Eternal Rock of Ages will deliver you. And the name of the Lord be glorified. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Now let's cry to God concerning our career and businesses. You know, we are reading this testimony to let you know that Almighty God is handling cases of all, of every aspect of our lives. This woman testifies, I have been battling with the spirit of stagnation for many years. I run a nursery and primary school here in Lagos. And for more than 11 years now, it was like moving around in circles. Children coming and going to the point where I began to contemplate closing down. One morning on the altar of the RCG prayering platform, there was a prophecy released which says, there was a proprietress here contemplating closing down our school, but God said it's coming true for her. I claimed that prophecy, and the tide shifted immediately. Fearfully, brethren, there was a major sudden shift I can't explain. From very few number of pupils and the virtually empty classes, parents began to troop in to register their children from nowhere. All our classes are filled beyond capacity. We had to buy emergency furniture because we ran out of furniture. Today, the situation is even getting more fearful because people are still coming, but no more space. Furniture all exhausted. We have even started a college beyond our expectation. I am afraid of this girl. I'm now praying to God to help me manage the crowd and give us another site. You can see. So you are going to use the particular testimony as a point of contrast. What are you experiencing in your business, in your career? I want to let you know that this God is still available. Mention the name of your career. Present your business to his hand and call upon the name of the Lord. Call upon the name of the Lord. The Lord intervened in the affairs of this woman. He said, fearfully speaking, what he saw was not ordinary miracle. It is a miracle that Almighty God performed that created fear. Everybody, they could not explain this. So call upon the name of the Lord that Almighty God himself will intervene in the affairs of your career, in the affairs of your business. Perhaps your business is already being closed down, as it were. Call upon the name of the Lord to bring life into your business, to bring life to your business, to resurrect your business, to resuscitate your business in the mighty name of Jesus, to breathe the breath of life to that career in the mighty name of Jesus. And to God be the glory. He's already performing signs and wonders and miracles right now in your life. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father God. In Jesus' name we pray. And I join my faith with your faith. And I decree right now that in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, every prayer you've raised, every petition you've presented before the Almighty God in a few minutes, receive the answer. In the mighty name of Jesus, expressly receive the answer. In the name of Jesus. Very soon, you'll be next in line to testify of the goodness of God, of the glory of the Lord, of the power of the Lord in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for having answered. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen and amen. Where we read at the text, I'm referring to Genesis chapter 8. That particular chapter is opened by one particular statement, and the statement is, "And God remembered Noah, and every other signs and wonders and miracles that were listed all came to being just because the Almighty God remembered Noah." In Psalm 136, verse 23 to 24, Psalm 136, verse 23 to 24, there the Bible says, "Who remembered us in our low estate, for his mercy endureth forever, and had redeemed us from our enemies, for his mercy endureth forever." You see, the remembrance came first before the deliverance followed. He remembered us when we were down there, been beaten down by the enemy. Nobody thought we would ever come out of the cage of the enemy. Then, in his mercy, this Almighty God remembered us. And see, the miracles that followed, the signs and wonders that followed, all the goodness of God, of the good thing that followed, the Bible says, "And had redeemed us from our enemies," just because his mercy endured forever. That's where we are looking at the fruits of remembrance. Now, the first thing we discover is that being remembered will definitely put an end to the storm one is engaging in. When one is remembered, no matter the raging storm, the matter the intensity of that particular storm, immediately, if somebody is remembered from above, the storm will just come to an end. So being remembered will definitely and we put an end to the storm one is engaging in. That's what happened in that Genesis chapter 8, verse 1 to 4 that we have read. You remember somebody we know very well in the Bible, called Joseph. Joseph was still toiling. He was still sweating inside the prison until a day came. Someone who ought to remember him had forgotten him before. But that morning, the name of that fellow happened to be the one Joseph helped. By the time Joseph interpreted the dream, and told the man, "When is he well with you? Remember me." Do you know, for 2 years, this man forgot Joseph. But a day came in the morning. Just at this morning or this afternoon or this evening, depending on where you are listening to this message, the time has come when you will be remembered. In Genesis chapter 41, verse 9, Genesis chapter 41, verse 9, the Bible says, "Then spoke the chief butler unto Pharaoh, saying, I do remember my fault this day." Remembrance of David came into his mind, came into his heart, came into his life, and that settled David. And that's the reason why immediately this man remembered, this man remembered Joseph. Suddenly, Joseph was sent for. And a prisoner in the morning became the prime minister in the evening because somebody remembered him. I have a feeling within me that somebody who had forgotten you before now, they begin to remember you. Stand on your feet wherever you are. Say, "Oh Lord, everyone that ought to remember me, that have forgotten me, put my remembrance to their heart today in the mighty name of Jesus." Pray that prayer. Pray that prayer. Pray that prayer. The Lord God himself is here today. There is power in being remembered. There is power in being noted. Call upon the name of the Lord. Almighty God, whoever had forgotten me, wherever they are, let them begin to remember me for good. In the mighty name of Jesus, right there at the federal level, right there at the state level, right there at the local government level, right there at international level, Almighty God, every bond here that ought to have remembered me, but they have forgotten me, Almighty God, open the tap and the key of my remembrance into their heart today. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. To be remembered, God can just lead somebody to open your file. That's what happened to Mordecai. The king could not sleep. Then the Holy Spirit, I believe, led the king to begin to open the file. And he saw there, this is what Mordecai had done to rescue the king. What had been done for him, to honor him? The people around, all the workers, they say, nothing. There's a spirit known as the spirit of nothing. When one had not been remembered, the spirit of nothing will begin to torment that people. Call upon the name of the Lord. Terminate from my life every spirit of nothing. Let someone who ought to remember me begin to remember me today. Call upon the name of the Lord. The Lord is here, and the name of the Lord be glorified. Thank you, Father God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. I congratulate you, because by the special grace of God, your file of remembrance has finally opened today in the mighty name of Jesus. And I decree into your life, oh, forever, we are referred that fellow is, or whatever position that fellow is occupying, at national level, global, whatever level, that ought to remember you, but they are forgotten. Before the sun set today, in that name that is above every other name, they will remember you. They will remember you in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen and amen. Number two, like Rachel, your remembrance can put an end to the barrenness of a long time. Barrenness of a long time. You remember Rachel? In Genesis chapter 30, verse 22 to 23, Genesis chapter 30, verse 22 to 23, the Bible says, and God remembered Rachel. You can see the miracles, the signs and wonders that followed. That is when God hearkened to her. She'd been praying before, but nobody listened to her because they had not been remembered. Today your prayer will be answered because the Lord God will remember you. And what was the result and effect of that one? And God opened her womb, and she conceived, and bare a son, and said, God had taken away my reproach. Because God remembered her, God opened her womb, she conceived, and that is how her reproach was taken away. Permanently. I don't know whether you are physically barren, or you are spiritually barren, psychologically barren, economically barren, politically barren, or whatever. In the nature of your barrenness, the Almighty God is here today to remember you. Call upon the Lord. You remembered Rachel, O God, and you took away her barrenness. Lord, today, remember me and take away my own barrenness and begin to call upon the Lord. What is the nature of your own barrenness? Right now, the Almighty God is here to answer your prayer. Call upon him right now. Call upon him right now. What is the nature of your own barrenness? The Lord God is here to terminate that particular barrenness out of your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Just because God remembered Rachel, all the miracles that Rachel needed followed. Call upon the name of the Lord right now. Oh God, in your name that is above every other name, every barrenness that I've been battling with, let it be terminated today. Remember me, remember me, remember me, remember me, remember me. Call upon the name of the Lord. Almighty God, remember me. King of glory, remember me. Lord of lords, remember me. Eternal God, remember me. Faithful God, remember me. I am that I am, remember me. Call upon the name of the Lord right now. Thank you, Father God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. As I join my faith with your faith right now, that remembrance from the throne of grace, that we permanently cancel any known barrenness in your life. Let God remember you today. In the mighty name of Jesus, I decree into your life that whatever is the nature of your own barrenness, because the Lord has remembered you, that barrenness is gone. In the name of Jesus, there be no any trace of any form of barrenness in your life any longer. Thank you, Father, for having answered. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen and amen. And number three, being remembered in the battlefield will bring victory over the enemies. When one is remembered and that fellow is in the battlefield, oh God, suddenly, victory will come. In Numbers chapter 10, verse 9. Numbers chapter 10, verse 9. And if you go to war in your land against the enemy that oppresses you, then ye shall blow an alarm with the trumpet, and ye shall be remembered before the Lord your God, and ye shall be saved from your enemies. So when the Almighty God remembers a man, such a man will definitely win over the enemies of his life. I believe and I know that by the special grace of God, that God is going to remember you today, you win battle over all your enemies. I do know, as you are going to pray right away, say, Lord, remember me and give me victory over this battle, over this battle, over this battle, over this battle. Begin to mention what are the battles you are fighting, Almighty God. Whenever God remembers a man in the battlefield or on the battlefield or around the battlefield, victory is sure for that particular fellow. Definitely, God said, you will be remembered and ye shall be saved from your enemies. The only way where one can be saved from his enemies, when God remembers us a fellow. To God be the glory. And I'm trusting God for you today that the Almighty God himself has decided to remember you in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, let me key in certain things. What are the things that God remembers? And take notice of it. According to Exodus chapter 32, verse 13. Exodus 32, 13. God remembers prayers of intercession. Oh, when Moses interceded, all what God remembered, that Moses has interceded to the people and the Lord. Say, well, because you have stood before me on behalf of these people, I won't destroy them any longer. Your intercession is not in vain. God is storing it and is entering into that particular, what I call the archive of remembrance. Number two, God remembers covenants according to Leviticus chapter 26, verse 42. Leviticus 26, verse 2. Anytime we present our case before him, one of the things God will remember is his covenant. He said, then will I remember my covenant with Jacob. Put your name there. Any covenant you have with the Almighty God. In the time of trouble, in the time of darkness, God remembers covenant. Number three, God remembers promises. His promises can never, never fail. In Psalm 105, verse 42 to 43. Psalm 105, 42 to 43. The Bible says, for he remembers his holy promise and Abraham his servant, and he brought forth his people with joy and his chosen with gladness. He remembers his promises. All the promises of God, just list them from the scriptures and present before the Almighty God. You have said this law, you have said this law, you are going to discover how your prayer will be answered because God remembers his promises. Number four, God remembers offerings. He remembers offerings. Every donation, every offering, every tithe, everything you are giving to God, God remembers it. That is Psalm 20, verse 3. Psalm 20, verse 3. God, he said, remember all thy offerings and accept thy burnt sacrifice. God remembers offerings. And I'm trusting God, the Almighty God himself, will remember your offering right now. It is time to pray. Wherever you are, stand on your feet right away and call upon the name of the Lord, because the Almighty God has decided to remember your offering right away. Thank you, Father God. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. For those of us who are listening and you are yet to give your life to Jesus, all the contact details will be displayed on the screen. We would love to hear from you. Please write to us. To God be the glory. Our Father and our God, we bless you for your goodness. We bless you for your faithfulness. We bless you for all mightiness. Take all glory. Take all honor. Take all adoration. We know that from this moment, you will remember us and your name will be glorified. Thank you, Father God. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen and amen. Wherever you are, shout a resounding hallelujah of remembrance. Let somebody shout a resounding hallelujah. Yeah.